Hello, everyone. Well, it happened yesterday. The trailer dropped. I haven't watched it yet. I've been iffy on whether I should or not, because we all know what movie trailers are like these days. They pretty much just try to give away all the best parts, but at the same time, we've got a month and a half to go until the movie comes out. So, that's a long time to try to go without spoilers, especially on the internet. And, I have videos to upload and to make, more reaction videos, more gaming videos. I'd like to do more Phasmophobia, all of that. So I can't just ignore YouTube. And I've already... Kind of what sparked all of this was that last night at work... Was it at work or was it... I think it might have been before I actually left for work. I got on YouTube on my phone and... Prince Whatever had left a community post asking who had seen the trailer. And even though there was no spoilers in it was just, have you seen the trailer? What did you think of it? Here's a little poll, whether you liked it or didn't. It still sparked the discussion in my brain about, how long until I start seeing thumbnails of videos analyzing the trailer or people posting community posts similar to that are asking questions about stuff in it. And how long before something gets spoiled. So, after some consideration, I have decided to watch the trailer. Because of the likelihood, the possibility, whatever you want to call it, of spoilers for things occurring in the film in the trailer, I am going to do a reaction to it here. I will try to do some editing on this video to try and hopefully avoid any copyright issues. We'll see. But on that note... I would like to think that I wouldn't run into any real copyright issues on just a trailer, but we all know how Hasbro can get. But so without further ado, let's get into this. Now, the first thing I want to say is that this looks amazing. This looks amazing. So a lot of people were upset when they found out that this was all that this was going to be CGI. I was not. I was, especially once we got to see a few looks at it and saw that it wasn't shit CGI. It was actually pretty good. I was over the frickin' moon. I've always wanted to see this kind of thing. So let's check the sound. I don't want it to be too loud. We'll put it about there. And let's. Let's do this.
Once upon a time, Earth ponies, pegasi, and unicorns live in harmony.
Why can't we be friends anymore?
Maybe one day, we'll figure it out.
What the?
Hi, new friend!
Unicorn attack!
Is anybody playing hide and seek? I see you!
Your son is safe now, ma'am.
I just want to take a second here to talk about a little something in this shot that I missed when I was first reacting to the trailer, and that is the poster you can see in the background on the wall. I'm sure someone in the community has talked about this already, but I haven't noticed any of the videos. Admittedly, I've not been getting a lot of pony videos in my recommended lately, but either way, that is some pretty dark, like, that is a full-on, like, government propaganda poster. Like, talking about evil pegasi, and, you have this big shadowy pegasus figure looming over the innocent, pure little earth pony figure in the foreground, and it's awesome, but it's also pretty freaking dark. Like, this, what this says to me is that this really is a dystopian future. Like we look at it and everything looks so bright and green and colorful and happy, and that's, you know, it looks that way, sure, but by equestrian standards, by the standards of pony kind, you know, friendship has failed here. Disharmony rules. This is a dystopia. And nothing, I think, says that better than that poster. I need to look. It seems almost like it's probably a reference to something, but I don't know what. I feel like I must be missing the reference if it is. But at the same time, I guess I'm not, because I'm registering it as... It seems like it's a reference, is all I'm saying. Like, something that's referencing something from a movie or something like that. But, I mean, like, just because this isn't, like, a completely desolated, like, wasteland, like frickin' Fallout Equestria or something, where the mega spells dropped and we've all been locked away in vaults for, you know, 2 centuries or whatever, it doesn't matter. This is still a dystopia. And that poster really, really says that more than anything to me. So, yeah. Just thought I'd chime in with that, seeing as I completely missed that poster when I was watching the trailer. It wasn't until I rewatched it later that I saw it. So, anyway, I'll let you get back to regularly scheduled reaction now. Enjoy.
Show me some magic. I can do this.
Ooh.
Ta-da! You don't have any magic? We did have it. It just poof, disappeared.
Hey. Oh god, they're all emo.
Izzy, we're going to Zephyr Heights.
The Pegasus City? We need to find out what happened to your magic and bring it back.
But the Pegasi are bad news.
Whoa! A unicorn and an earth pony?
Okay, well, this day just got a whole lot more interesting.
We'll need glitter. Lots of glitter.
Yay, makeovers! I love makeovers.
Gorgeous!
Come on, every pony.
Bring forth the ultimate challenge!
I don't play. I win.
Big talk for a little pony.
I think you'll find I'm average height.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, one photo. Okay. Well, first of all... Oh, shit. Was my face clipping over it the whole time? Oh, well. Less spoilers than I kind of thought. I mean, I think we got a little glimpse of something that's going to happen when magic gets brought back. Like, you saw, like, the Pegasi getting, like, lifted up with, like, colors all over their wings and stuff, but, I'm gonna have to rewatch this at some point and try and focus on it a little bit better. Just, my brain just kind of got locked up at the reaction of the Earth Ponies when Izzy showed up. And I somehow knew when Hitch did that bit with the kid that wasn't going to be her kid. I have no problem. And to be honest, now finally getting to properly see... Which, admittedly, I haven't seen, you know, all the little videos that they released leading up to this, but this is the first time I've gotten to actually properly see, like, the characters speaking with the voices. And I'm fine with it. Like, I genuinely don't have a problem with their voices. I was afraid that I wouldn't like them as much. Sadly, seeing as she's the character that looked the most interesting to me when she first showed up, Zip's voice is the one I'm least fond of. But Sunny's fits perfectly. Of course, Izzy's is... From the minute that we first got, like, the little trailer revealing the cast, when I heard Kimiko Glynn speaking, I was just like, well, that voice just fits perfectly. But everyone else, it was kind of, I can't see it. But now, yeah, no, that just, it's perfect. The fucking goddamn dance-off shit. Okay, it's definitely going to be funny. I don't have a problem with that. I think that scene where we see Izzy and Sunny kind of traveling through different biomes, I'm guessing we're going to get like a musical montage there, a la Shrek, almost. I'm looking forward to it. I'm gonna try not to get too super hyped up, but this is looking fine to me. You know, I have no problem with this at all. Wow. I like how everyone thinks the Pegasi are bad news. That's interesting. I wonder what, Also, the fucking unicorns just being, like, all emo and shit now without their magic. Just that one kid just sitting there going, oh. I'm good with this. I'm good with that trailer as well. It didn't give too much away. It just sort of flashed everything by really quickly once things got started. So you just kind of got a bit of what I'm gonna guess is like the first 10 minutes of the movie, you know, up to Izzy's appearance and that freak out. I mean, admittedly, it would have been nice to see that unspoiled, just this absolute freak out of everyone. But, you know, it doesn't matter. I'm sure that the movie's going to have plenty more to offer. Oh, God. I will say it, though, that now I'm even more convinced that they're going to have to try and keep this cast for the series because they do work. You know, again, Zip is the only one that I'm a little, her voice just kind of sounds a little too normal to me, which is an odd thing to say, because so does Sunny's, but Sunny's kind of got the Twilight thing going on, and Twilight's voice, no offense towards Tara Strong, obviously, but she kind of had just a normal voice compared to every pony else, but Pip's voice, I'm now looking at Pip as being the rarity of this series after that line of loving makeovers, but then again, with her being advertised as being like a pop star, I guess that kind of makes sense. But at the same time, I don't want to compare them all too much to the characters from Gen 4, because they aren't those characters. This isn't G4, this is G5. It is its own story, its own... Well, it's the same universe, but, you know... And now I'm wondering, because see, is he talking about how we had magic, but then it just kind of went poof? Is it, were they like told, was she told stories by her dad about, you know, how once upon a time they had magic, but then it disappeared? The same way that Sunny was told stories of the days of friendship by her dad? Or was it a more recent thing? I don't know, I guess we'll find out in a month and a half. That wait is just, it just feels so long now. I'm stoked, I'm hyped, this looks good. I'm genuinely happy with this. I'll be rewatching the trailer later, maybe immediately after finishing this. But, so Now that I've managed to drag a reaction to like a 2-minute trailer out for 12 minutes, I guess I'm a good YouTuber, aren't I? I will see you in whatever my next video is. Harmonia Invictus.
Open your eyes, life is all around. You don't have to be so alone. Take a good look at this world you found and breathe. Now you're finally home.